I'm at the Ericsson booth here at IMC 2024. I want to show you incredible things, but the first one I'm showing you, a robotic dog called Rocky. Let's get started.
Namaskar. Welcome. Ericsson booth mein aapka swagat hai.
Namaskar. So meet Rocky. This is Ericsson's robotic toy dog out here. Well, it's already woken up. So iske saath you can do a lot of things out here, including, of course, it'll greet you, it'll shake hands with you, it'll dance with you, it'll walk with you, it'll actually follow you. But the main reason that they have it out here is what they've done with a 5G network with low latency, like what Ericsson can carry. Imagine this deployed on a factory floor in a house, somewhere that you actually need real-time patrolling. Think about at that time if there's a fire. It can take a real video in real time, get in touch with emergency services, get in touch with the people who own the factory, and be able to do something about it immediately. If there's a break-in, if someone's walking around with maybe the safety is not absolutely right. This is like a patrolling dog that can do it without getting tired, and you can program it to do whatever you really like. So it's fun, it's play, and it's also working really, really hard. Imagine robotics and a 5G network can do together. So congratulations, absolutely wonderful the way Ericsson has showcased all that they're doing, including what you're doing now and the future. By the way, the robotic dog is great. So let's talk a little bit about Ericsson and 5G in India. And I want to start off with maybe the most important question. What's the role Ericsson is playing to take 5G adoption to a whole new level here in India? How are you working with the Indian service providers? What's your role there?
I think our role goes beyond the network rollout. I mean, the first thing is, in order to be effective in 5G, the spectrum allocation is critical. So we work a lot with the GSMA, we work a lot with the Indian government in order to do the right spectrum allocation. Spectrum guarantee bandwidth, capacity,
right,
and that is critical for 5G. India has become the country that is carrying more traffic in 5G across the world.
Really?
It's becoming the country where you can see by user the highest capacity per month. 29 gigabytes.
Yeah, Indians are famous for that.
But then you need 5G because there is no other way. So around this technology, what we are trying to do is also to cooperate with the Indian government in order to move from connectivity to use cases. 5G is different in the sense that this connectivity will allow new use cases. Autonomous transportation, big improvement in water distribution, power distribution, because it will allow to connect many, many, many other things. So the government has set an initiative in order to deploy 100 labs across India, and we are part of that. So 5G will introduce virtual reality, artificial intelligence. So in that technologies for education will be critical.
Are there global examples, because you're a global company where you've done the rollout in multiple countries across the world for 5G networks. Are there examples from there that you're bringing here for solution providers to take forward, use cases to take forward? Or is India now teaching the world? Which way is it?
Well, in a way, it's both ways. Huh? Okay. But let me give you some examples. Sure. The key use case that has been developed in the United States, which is another front runner, is fixed wireless access. Fixed wireless access is a technology that allows to connect a household through mobile technology. It's more convenient because you can deploy it immediately. It guarantees high bandwidth because 5G is in bandwidth performance is very similar to fiber optic. But you can deploy it immediately and much faster than fixed assets. So that, the front runner is the US, but India is catching up really quickly. So today, the US has more than 10 million connections, India has 6 million.
Yes.
But the run rate in the US is 4,000 per day. Here, some of the operators like Jio, they are reaching peaks of several thousands, dozens of thousands per day. So I will not mention the exact number, but it's much higher than the United States. Where India is leading is enhanced mobile broadband. So India is really unleashing the usage. There's no other country that can compare to India when it comes to usage. For that reason, you need 5G capacity as well.
Is Ericsson playing a big role? Because that's the part that I think becomes super important. We've got all the talent here. We've got all the users. We've got Ericsson to help get the hardware and the network and the experience out here. But what about things like solution providers and their APIs and everything else? Is there a role you're playing there? Because that's almost as mission critical as anything else.
If you think on network evolution, the main shift that is coming to the networks is they are moving from purpose-built networks where you have hardware and software specifically dedicated for the network performance into open architectures. That means that the network will be able to interact in a native mode with many other elements, with cloud infrastructure, with digital services. The way you organize all that is through APIs. And what we are trying to do is to expose all the capabilities of the network with API interfaces, so anyone can connect to all the network functionality. Okay. When that happens, your network moves from being a physical asset into being a software platform.
Right.
When you are a software platform, you can open your capabilities to new communities, like the community of app developers, and they will create hundreds of thousands of new use cases for you.
One of the interesting things that's been happening now is that a lot of people are now talking about 5G and AI becoming almost like, you know, they're like bedmates, have to be together all the time. But already there is some talk about 5G, AI, and 6G.
Yeah.
So let's do a little bit of future forecasting. Let's do a little bit of looking into the crystal ball. What about just AI for the normal user combined with 5G moving on to 6G? How do you see this whole thing play out?
Okay, it's 5-year hype. 5G is the mobile technology that has been adopted faster. 2 years
than
ahead.
Than any other, yes.
Than any other, 2 years right. ahead of the deployment of 4G.
India, I think, has the record of having more 5G phones sold before the 5G network went live, right?
Yeah. That was the kind of excitement we had.
India has reached 90% coverage in only 22 months. So that is the level of deployment of 5G. So now coming into 6G, the 6G question. If you go through the path of making your network open and programmable, then you can embed new technologies and connect that ecosystem. One of the key technologies is artificial intelligence, you mentioned it. The other one is edge computing. So you need to bring the content really close to the user, and the user could be a car in order to make a decision, but you need to bring the right content really close to it so they can make quickly that decision. Mm-hmm. When you bring all that together in a platform, what you're creating is a network platform that is basically full by artificial intelligence and edge computing. In order to make their own decisions, and in order to be predictable in the way it's going to behave. That is the path into 6G. In order to make it possible, there is a long way to go.
Okay.
You know that the big debate right now in 6G is spectrum allocation. Okay. What type of spectrum needs to be allocated to 6G in order to be efficient? But what is critical in order to be efficient on 6G is that we move the current architecture of networks that are purpose-built, so hardware and software dedicated, into horizontal networks that are open to others, so we can embed new type of technologies, and that will be the baseline in order to build an efficient 6G network.
When do you think India will be the absolute leader in terms of the number of 5G users in a particular country? Is it a if or is it a when?
It's a when.
So as you can see, the robotic dog has been packed away and the day is over here at IMC. But lots more coming from Ericsson out here because there's so many interesting things happening. Can you imagine we're at 5G, but talk of 6G, AI, and what all it can do? So we'll explore a lot more of that in our next video.